We're going to Japan. We're going to Japan. Hi ho the Mario. We're going to Japan.
Some mornings I'll feel happy. Some mornings I'll feel creative. Some mornings I'll feel sad. Some mornings I'll be longing for my loved ones.
This is my friend. She's my friend. And we're getting
my
married.
My boyfriend.
We are getting married on November 28th. Chad is a sexy, handsome genius.
After you, gentlemen.
Chad.
Great drummer.
Great drummer. Great drummer. Tall, tall, tough geek.
So, Chad, how are you? What's your philosophy in life?
Have a good time all the time.
So, very special man.
Okay, these are special seeds.
What's up?
This is the opposite of crack.
These seeds will make you feel, will give you love and protection.
Don't be so pig-headed.
I'm pig-headed. I have
don't
a head
be so
of a pig.
Pig-headed.
And hey, you know what?
Oh!
Down my neck!
Okay, good.
Thank you for waiting, ladies and gentlemen. Japan Airlines Flight 61 for Tokyo is going to start boarding soon. Please proceed to gate 104 for boarding.
She said, oh, your friend, you're so big.
Yeah, well, you know, of course I... Well, you know.
He's talking about Robbie, actually.
Yeah. Oh. Anyways, I'm hoping that I've spiritually and emotionally evolved to the point where I'm looking for a higher love.
Looking for just... a higher love.
It's just
that,
no, he's
this much talent. She's got this much talent.
Louis, I lost my boarding pass. Simple fact.
He doesn't speak English. I'll tell him.
Hi, peppers.
I really love chili peppers.
I love chili peppers.
I love you.
Give it away, give it away, give it away, nah.
And it's a bridge downtown. It's red as blue sun blood.
I'm a little pee.
I like red hot peppers.
Sometimes I feel like I don't have a partner. Sometimes I feel like
my only friend. It's the city I'm living, the city of
angels. Our main thing right now is trying to stick together and to listen to each other as best as we can and to keep our hearts very open and honest and vulnerable for all the people of Japan.
I recently had my stomach cut open. I had an alien inside of my body.
I got one. Yeah, let's start with John.
I'd like to say that my message to all of Japan is that to embrace the beautiful culture and tradition of your country.
In search of the wild panda, the Tokyo panda, the urban panda, the urban teenage panda, which are not endangered species today in Tokyo's climate. The red-headed clan, they only come out during the winter. They speak in pantomime. I think this is the leader of the clan here. Hi. If only I knew the sacred panda call. The mating call of the panda. They're actually too young to mate, but they do respond to the call, if you know it. These are the elusive pandas. You notice the pandas, they're not that comfortable in the presence of other animals, so they try to elude us. Hi. Good afternoon. How are you? Oh, konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Nice to meet you. Is life good? Are you teenagers in Tokyo, living on the edge? Yeah? Pretty much? Oh, I want to know, do the shoes come with walking instructions? No. No? No instructions? It is a pleasure. Thank you very much. Domo arigato. God bless. All the best. Thanks for taking the time. Classic panda sighting here in the streets of Tokyo.
And John is such a pure artist, and he doesn't care about the reward, he doesn't care about any of the things that come with rock stardom or being in a band, or any of the things that someone might think would be the fringe benefits of being in a band. Those things are absolutely no concern to him. He just lives for the process of making music and for the process of surrendering his body and his soul to the spirits, you know, and letting music flow through him. It's all he wants to do. And he's really dedicated his life to just doing that and to creating good feelings in the world by doing that. And I
hate to disappoint, you know, the Japanese men, but I'm not bisexual.
I'm not bisexual, but I do like to buy sex.
We all were at a point with our life a couple of years ago where we saw very clearly that we were all at the same page of our life, you know, and that we could, that by joining together that we were capable of making some good art, you know.
Some of our best, you know, music comes from becoming unconscious.
Things that are like expressed in weakness, I think we can express with strength, you know. We'll be right back.
Konnichiwa. Hello. Yes, this is the assistant manager.
When I was young, I wouldn't have minded that bad. If it was me, I'd be bummed.
Being a man with many hotel rooms.
Wrestling match, me or Aki Bono. Chad Rowan is his real name, incidentally. How much is 245 kilos? 500 and some odd pounds?
Oh, no, no.
Do you ever drive like this?
No, I'm not.
Johnny's in the basement mixing up the medicine. Now I'm on the table.
That's too fast.
It's Johnny's in the basement mixing up the medicine. I'm on the pavement thinking about the government. Man in the trench coat, badge out, laid off. Said he got a bad copy, won't forget, paid off.
Thing to do, touring-wise, to come down to the Southern Hemisphere and be in the middle of summertime and play shows where you have days off and days on and big days off and big days out.
To honor the number one platinum album,
triple platinum in New Zealand. This is for John Frusciante. He's of Italian heritage.
This I would like to give to Flea. It's got the carved green stone.
Are you getting all that?
Yes.
eBay. Yeah. Our new cover.
Here it is, the jacket cover. It's the other side.
I'm signing just as fast as I can, man!
My favorite is Flea. Yeah, Flea and Anthony.
Chili's fucking rock. I love you, Anthony Kiedis, and I wish I could meet you.
I fucking love the Foo Fighters. It's like, where is it? It's like, no, it's like Foo Fighters, isn't it?
My name's David Eric Grohl. I'm a Capricorn. I'm 31 years old.
Will they knock us out of number one again? I fucking hate
that. They always do that.
Fucking that Around the World song, man. I'm totally into it. You know, I'll tell you something kind of cool about the Chili's. When we played with them in Paris, one of the coolest things, in the middle of the show, Flea was having trouble with the bass or something like that. And Anthony tried to console him, right, because Flea was obviously sort of bummed. And Anthony and Flea hugged, and the crowd went nuts.
This is good.
Oh, yeah. What's happening, cousin? Sturdy, stout
he's
mad.
He's sturdy bastard.
Yeah, sturdy, stout-hearted mad.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to sing Other Side.
Me either.
I'm going to come in for that note and I'm not going to be able to hit it.
On the other side.
That's what it's going to sound like.
Right, well, we did it.
I slide!
Okay, fuck Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I just did push-ups.
You really look like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I don't look like anything like Schwarzenegger.
Organic here.
Instead of easily.
It was kind of early for Easily.
Mind you, I spent a lot of time thinking about it.
Guys, I'm a little weak.
Yeah, you really want to do that thing and get that down?
I didn't figure it out.
Yeah, that's
fine. Let me go back.
That's okay.
Mike.
That's it, Mike.
Non-smoking, clean, healthy living people in this one.
There's like six tapes in there. Yeah, I just put them all in one place.
I'm the C3.
No, you're looking in, there's two, they're in two different compartments.
Okay. Were you filming my bum?
Yeah, he's good. He's a healthy
nose, throat, and tongue specialist.
Could you lead me to John Frusciante?
I know it helps, you know, to do my normal, like, stretching and stuff that I do before the show and relaxing. When Nine Inch Nails is on before us, I can't relax. I can't concentrate on stretching. Or...
The girl was asking me about our pre-stage routine. I was like, green tea, ginseng, stretching, meditating, techno, warming up. Chad,
cigarettes and beer.
Chad's about three beers and a ginseng. I said when it gets into four and five and six,
trouble
is in the air.
If I get here this early, I can easily have three. I could easily have all six.
Right. You're right.
I didn't tell him about the bottle of wine I had at dinner.
This is for all the redheads, male and female. Dyed or natural, especially the cousins of Fleek.
This is my
cousin.
Hello.
My first message is for the Australian people, and that is I'll be there at 3. Bring the bowling ball, the cream cheese, and the dynamite. Meet me in the bathhouse and try not to be late.
I've been listening to them since I was about 13.
I love their music, that's all I can really say.
How would I describe their music? Loud.
Funky. Freaky.
You sit there and you listen to some of the lyrics and you just, wow.
Things aren't up, you know, like there. I just have to put them on and I'm up here.
1 hour. I have a lot to do in the next hour.
We're 40.
I mean, I just thought you liked it a little shorter than mustache.
Well, I thought you didn't, so. And actually, I could see that in the light. Just
about a 8 or 9 foot gap right here between rocks. I'm gonna do a little trick for you here.
That guy in that shop's
amazing,
is it?
What?
Yeah,
hi.
Sweet
pass by.
My
name's Antoinette.
My name's Anthony. Have you found it for me? Wondering if I could have an autograph. Is that all right? If it's just okay, I don't want to interrupt or impose anything. Just somewhere over here would be nice.
Wait.
Hot Chili Peppers. We'd like to thank the people of Sweden, the magazines of Sweden, the workers of Sweden, the rich people of Sweden, the prostitutes of Sweden, the drug addicts of Sweden, the royalty of Sweden, the lovely young ladies of Sweden, and all the high school students and preschool students of Sweden, and all the nannies and uncles and aunts of Sweden for these beautiful Rock Björnen awards.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate everything you've done for me.
Sacred ginseng ritual. This is what I do for my bandmates every night because I want them to feel good.
It's that 10-hour rule. What is it?
It's a new brand of ginseng. It doesn't sit real good.
Bad mojo.
This is the one and only last cup of the good shit that I save for you.
Oh, really? Thank you.
All right. Whoa. Strong like a motherfucker. Bitter. Ooh, I'm gonna have to pass on that.
Are there any of those ginseng teas around?
Yes, there really are. Flavor.
Is it alright?
Of herbal technology.
Is it alright?
Okay.
Is it alright?
Yeah, it's good.
It's fine.
The main thing is that it's just for guys on stage, you know. So they are playing music for us.
There's a lot of energy out there, Flea.
This is a Melbourne taxi driver.
My mom's here in Melbourne right now.
I know. That's what I was asking about this morning.
Even when he was fighting Holyfield, he was kind of statuesque looking.
Tyson is no doubt punching the shit out of this guy right now.
Bust him up, Mike.
Boxing.
Oh! Get up!
Get up!
Get up, you little bitch!
What? He's good!
What?
He's just good. He's been doing after the business falls down.
Tyson made mincemeat of a non-worthy opponent. There were not two athletes of a kind caliber. Tired of looking like a dandelion that's, you know, gone into a puffball. I'm waiting for my brains to blow away in the wind with a haircut like this. I like having long bangs, but yeah. But they've gotten a bit trashed at the bottom.
Yep.
I like having sideburns since I can't actually grow any of my own. All that kind of shaggy business down there, you could whack that off. All this. Oh, very nice. I'm clean now. Thank you.
Yeah?
May.
was he pulled some guy's nut right out of his sack.
What?
He went up to a guy and grabbed his nut and pulled it testicle out of his fucking
Who
sack.
Did?
John Bonham.
That's a fucking folklore if I ever heard
it. It wouldn't come out. It wouldn't rip.
Said
the skin
said
wouldn't
he,
rip.
Said he pulled it out of his nutsack.
That's rock and roll folklore.
You guys, let's show everybody we care, show these people we care about them, show them we love each other and we care about ourselves.
Mostly stuff for hire. I do sell beards and mustaches.
Beards and mustaches.
This is a handsome piece right here. This should make Tex Avery proud. Would you mind just putting those on real quick?
You got big lashes.
Boobs.
What kind of a wig are you recommending for me? So this is kind of your Ramones collection here?
That's a pretty sick look.
Woo! Fu Manchu me. I might just be like one of those big freaks, you know? Just like a big... Talk to me, Dad.
You wanna step the fuck outside and talk about this? I didn't think so.
Imagine your eyebrows.
Is that a pickup line? I didn't think so.
By the way, I knew this guy. I knew this guy. I knew him. His name was Alan Bechera, and he was a good man, Vietnam vet. Did I fool you?
No, I just thought you were some Mexican restaurant guy that Dick knew in the Western States.
You guys know where I can find the big day out?
Right here. You're here,
is it?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Really well.
My what?
Come on, show it, show
it. Come on now, come on now. What do you feel when you come to a place like this?
Love.
Love.
Openness.
Name's Alan.
Lynn.
Alan.
Shannon, mate. Foo Fighters, pretty good, and Chili Peppers, very keen to see Chili Peppers.
I've seen them more than one time.
The bass player, his choice.
I like the guitar player. You wouldn't know where I can get any hot dogs, maybe with some onions on top. Have you taken any prescriptive medication for the day?
Taking this fucked up drug, right?
What called what?
I don't know.
G'day.
Alan Bechera, Hollywood, California. How are you? 1, 2, 3, 4.
You have to shake hands.
Okay. Are you in line?
I'm in line.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I didn't know Neil Sean was playing guitar for me.
Some kid said, hey, you dropped your pass, man. Sorry, fucking Baba.
You had a big sign up front that says Fairfax High at the big marquee.
Yes.
We used to, Anthony and I used to change the letters around. There was a teacher we hated called Mr. Platt, Mr. Don Platt. We would change it around so it said Don Platt sucks anus. No one would come to school in the morning like, Don Platt sucks anus. And then,
I write music, I play guitar, and I spend all my time doing it. If the band had to do my schedule, they would be dead. This is the last show tonight, you know, so we've been here for a couple of weeks, and it's been good. I don't know, I think there's something funny about the air here for me.
Yeah.
I wake up every morning feeling like funny, like...
We make people feel good for a living. Let's make them feel good.
Sean's back there doing tootskies.
Ah!
God damn it!
What's up?
Coming to you to chop it up. You got mohawks, that's what we got.
The half one?
Look at that! This natural hawk right here?
Yeah.
Take that baby and do a straight line all the way back.
Look
at that!
Yeah!
I'm the fire starter. I'm the fire starter. No, I'm the fire starter.
We have special guests. They've come to visit us. They've come to share their philosophy of love and of enlightenment with us. These people are coming to share their grace, their style, their love with us. Who do we got? Julia Butterfly. Wayne Dyer. Ladies and gentlemen, Carolyn Mace. John Lurie. The coolest guy in the world, Chris Rock. Woody Harrelson is my brother. They are blonde redhead and they will greet you when you arrive in heaven.
You're next question, please.
Mr. President, Mr. President,
Mr. President,
Mr. President,
Mr. President, Mr. President.
Bill? Mr. President, I heard you're on tour with the Foo Fighters. Are they imposters?
It's time to let the freaks into your house.
You always have to be so zenny. Why
are you so zenny wacky like that?
Why you think you are funny? This is a real picture. This is juvenile behavior. This is not funny. It's something that has got your name.
Yo, man.
Oh, thank you.
Fucking love it. That was fantastic. I never got bored. I was surprised when it was over because it went a lot quicker than one would have expected. The songs that people seem to respond to the most are the slow ones. You know? I mean, they rock to the fast ones, but the slow ones were like the anthems for them. Let's see who can stay up on their hands and lungs. Okay, here we go.
Down?
Yes.
Two out of three is standard.
Marcus Welby, go.
Marcus Welby.
start laughing, that'll mess you up.
Wow,
that is... I like that!
Underhand
play! Can I go underneath there?
Alright,
go ahead.
Alright.
I hate losing. I do. You're not gonna be able to sleep tonight.
I'll sleep just fine. After I beat him, I'll sleep just fine.
No, I beat you twice a
day. I know you did. I mean, maybe a little later, we'll give it a little time, just relax.
How about a...
There's a backgammon table.
Papa.
Backgammon, are you any good at backgammon?
I'll kill you in backgammon.
I rule it backgammon.
I don't want to embarrass you, came all the way out here
I'll
to be on
crush you
internet TV show.
Dude. I'm winning this game, I guarantee it. He practices that stuff every single day. I come in, I haven't done a handstand in like a decade. Okay, fine, he beats me on that, but you're not going to beat me on this.
I think that I'm in the process of whipping your ass right now.
Oh, you got to be kidding me. I'm in great shape here. Do you want to bet on this game? Here comes trouble.
You get a book of the floor, 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 you get a book of the...
I feel a five coming on so strong. Come on, five.
Oh, we got 2-1. Let me see. 2-1.
What was that?
What's it called? Wait, is it a backgammon when a guy is still groveling up there when you get all your shit out?
Oh, Lord help you. Oh, God. I guess I just keep rolling then, don't I? What's it called when you're still on the bar there? That's ugly.
Barely squeak by a victory after I rompled you in the last game. After it was like a...
You didn't rompel me, Stillskin.
Everybody has a soundtrack for their life.
I'm going to promote a film that I narrated called Grass. About how pot became the most maligned plant on the planet. It talks about how the government developed it into a, you know...
A bad guy?
Yeah. Turned it into this dangerous threat. But I don't know. In a free country, you get to grow whatever you want. You get to smoke whatever you want, in my mind.
Does Grass talk about, the value of weed clothing? And
it mostly talks about pot. It doesn't talk about hemp.
Right.
I mean, I make the distinction between hemp and pot.
Right.
Yeah. This is him.
Think for yourself. Form your own opinions. Trust your own judgment.
I didn't start surfing until I was 32 or 33.
How old are you?
37.
I started when I was 30.
I just like sitting on a surfboard and waiting though. You know, I like that sitting. You know what I'm talking about? That's my favorite. Getting a wave is great, but I just like paddling out real early right when the sun rises and just sitting out there waiting.
Yeah, just feeling the vibe out there. If you're uptight or stressed a little bit, it just takes everything away.
Yeah, it totally does. And it's like, for me, it's like just that sitting there going up and down. It's like the world breathing, you know, and you get in tune with it and just get totally in tune with the inhale and the exhale of the world and it just relaxes everything. And that's my theory, that's what it is, that's why.
It facilitates psychic phenomena, it facilitates telepathy.
It's improvisation, you know how it is. Sometimes it's amazing and sometimes it sucks, you know, but that's the whole beauty of it. It's the gamble of
the risk.
Trusting in whatever's going to happen, you know.
Do you decide before you come on?
Well, then I don't know how
you
pop out a grade on it at the end, because I felt it was amazing, you know, and like you may have some expectation, but...
I guess I just like compare it to other ones, like times when I know I really felt like I totally let go of everything, and like we all let go of holding on to any idea of it and just surrendering completely to music.
I think the most important thing to learn is how to relax.
Yeah, watch the Chili Peppers, buy all their shit, soup, Chili Pepper soup, whatever they have. Merchandise, buy their shit.
Hammer
is actually choreographing the Wu-Tangs next door.
Young MC's doing a cover of Give It Away. That's what I hear. It's really big.
How was just doing an outfit? So I'll get a little.
You didn't realize Snoop Dogg was a star. That's the same thing I didn't realize.
the biggest selling record in the world, The Kid comes out, Eminem, and he's got
Eminem's
the kids going, he's got the kids going. Yeah. And I'm like, wow, he's riding high. He finishes, he goes off the stage. And on comes Snoop and Dre, and it got 1,000 times bigger.
But it's really, Snoop Doggy Dogg is a fucking star. Snoop Doggy Dogg.
And Eminem was rapping his ass off. It wasn't like he didn't have his shit together. He had fucking practiced his shit.
And yeah, I realize it, you know, you're a heterosexual guy, you don't realize these things. Most of the guys on the show are on the Dre tour, they're like pudgy guys or whatever. Snoop Dogg's cut, fucking tall guy, 6'3".
He's cut right here.
He's got all this shit. He's got the face.
Yeah.
And he's got hair out to fucking. He's a rock star.
He's got the suit. And
he's a rock star. He's got long hair. He's fucking, you know. I mean, I had disgusting jokes that, you know, went nowhere about women's periods. You know,
I still have that.
You know.
I guess I'm still in my book, though.
Yeah. You live, you learn. I had long hunks on porno. But you get me, Renee, Morgan Freeman, and myself. So.
Enough said. Everyone will leave it.
So you dissing Jersey?
No, I'm feeling very pro Jersey.
Okay, because sometimes, you know, it's like, okay.
No, I'm going the opposite. I'm going pale.
Let's try some shit. We're only in Jersey.
No, it's not that. To me, this is a big show because it's so close to New York.
I get like that about Cincinnati. I'll try anything in Cincinnati.
Ghostface Track 13.
Is it the best record ever?
It's really.
Ever?
It's absolutely
phenomenal. Is it the most. Is the best.
It's the hardest, most naked, raw.
It is everything
hardcore.
People hate about rap, and it's everything you love about rap.
It's just the greatest. Yeah, it's nothing. I just love it.
I love it.
Yeah, for me, it's like the essence of the whole greatness of the rhythm.
Yeah.
Yeah, no frills, no fucking anything.
There's no credits on it either. There's no.
It's just
sample
awesome.
Clearance.
I like the whole
just,
record, though.
I love the whole album, but
yeah.
That one thing was like, whoa.
Yeah, it's totally just the craziest sounding track.
Who's the cool guy in town?
Yeah, let me know all those things so I can incorporate them.
Who's
into
the coach
the
of the basketball team?
I wanted to build their confidence, you know?
They need that because I was good.
And I think they had a sneak.
You came to the New York show.
Yeah, I went to like four. I had a sneak.
Well, it takes you four.
Hey, it was the New York show.
I've always looked at it as a
show. And the New York show has to be correct. Go way back. Anthony writes all my jokes, and I wrote other side. Me.
Just the intro.
Yeah.
It actually started off as a joke he was working at, and I was like, you know, this works as like a serious song if you think about
really,
it.
This
in
is
fact, it's not that funny. Really,
it'll never be funny.
We were just there for staying this week.
All right. Well, glad you made it.
Yeah,
I'll be back.
It's been a while, but we'll go back.
I will be back.
Nice. Good to see you.
Yeah, you look great. You were totally wrong about...
Yeah, you were way wrong. You were so wrong.
Let me look like an asshole.
To New York, and there were all these little clubs and options, and he's like, you want to go see Lounge Lizards?
You went to see us?
I was like, what the fuck is Lounge Lizards?
You saw us a long time ago?
So long, like 81, 82?
Yeah. Jean-Michel Basquiat had a going away party for him. The band was going to go on tour, and so he made it into this, like, he invited Steve Rubell, Bianca Janker, Andy Warhol, Francesco Clemente, Wim Wenders. I invited Wim Wenders, Tom Waits, Jarmusch, and it was like, you know, it was kind of this amazing thing. It was a Mr. Chow's, and it was like, everybody was like, and so then Andy, so no big deal. But then, when Andy Warhol died and those diaries came out, he said it was the, you know, he's going to stop hanging around with fags because gonna start hanging around with artists now, because this was the best party he'd ever been, or he'd been to in 10 years. And the guy, the woman who transcribed the, they were just on tape, so this woman had transcribed it, and she turned me and Tom Waits into John Waits.
Remember playing with Hello?
Sure.
Back in the day?
Yeah, I loved
it. What was your shit called? Hammerheads?
Dr. Hammerhead. Remember when we were going to have you play in the Lounge Lizards?
Yeah. The fact is that I really had barely touched a guitar in like 4 years or something.
Yeah.
I remember
assistant calling me and said, I just talked to Fashanti. He said, I don't like the way you guys are handling this, and hung up. So I guess he's not going on the tour. Every day?
Yeah.
You play on the bus all the time, I guess.
I don't like the feeling of going on stage if I haven't touched the guitar all day.
Yeah.
So I practice on the bus, and when I go up on stage, I feel stressful.
When you start to do one of the hits, the slower ones, and they start to sing along en masse, does that ever piss you off?
No, I just have to focus on hearing the pitch of the song.
Yeah.
Because my throat gets so messed up that going to the natural place where I sing songs isn't always possible. I have to find a different place in my head to sing.
Range-wise, like higher or lower?
Not higher or lower, just like, you know, sometimes you sing from here, you know, mid-ranges and shit.
Yeah.
And if my voice is fucked up and I'm like, oh, I gotta find a weird place to sing from.
Yeah. I also know from singing with this Marvin Pontiac, you can mess yourself up completely, like something that should be just completely normal, and then once you get it in your head that you have to think about it, then you just hex yourself. How old are you now?
37.
So do you think about like being 45 and doing this?
I don't know, you're gonna be the next
Bill Wyman?
I can't really.
You get out there and you think, God, I don't want to give it away tonight, but you have to, or how does that work?
That's one of the only songs, sometimes I feel like that.
But that's what I was talking about the kind of the rock out kind
but
of
But only thing. When I get insecure, when I feel like I have to do certain things, like physical things in it. Like if I would just relax on it more, I probably wouldn't feel that way as much. But sometimes I feel like I have to like ridiculous knee squats. What they really want is just for Flea to be there and for him to be him. And that's the number one thing. It doesn't matter if he jumps around.
You can be great in rehearsal, you can get chills in rehearsal, but there's another almost warlike intensity that happens because of the crowd. I never even look at the crowd until halfway through. Does the energy of the crowd frighten you?
Hell
no. No.
Chad did remarkably well, no? I thought Chad did great. Did you keep going? I couldn't tell if it was
hurting. Those guys are
you.
Dead. They're dead little fucking
kufas. I couldn't tell if it was hurting you or not.
No, the balls and the sparkles didn't. The spaghetti did.
The spaghetti, no.
It spoke about your history of drug addiction the other day and how you cleaned yourself up.
It's the challenge of a lifetime, for mm-hmm. sure. I'm pretty grateful for the challenge. Because without it, I think I may have never been privileged to discovering the big picture.
One of the common qualities, or one of the certainly dominant, is the issue of control that people have.
Mm-hmm.
And the loss of feeling that they can't control their external life, suffering from the inability to control their inner life,
mm-hmm.
The fear of being out of control, and not almost wanting to drown that fear. So they can live in the illusion that they are in control.
Yeah. I think there's a part of it which is, wanting to take this shortcut to a relationship with God. I think that's sort of where the name Getting High comes from.
Either you release the need to control your life mm-hmm. and give in to some greater power that would direct your ascension
mm-hmm.
or your getting high process.
Right.
Or you insist on doing it your way, which would be the mechanical drug way altered state, in which case you can't outrun the mystical process.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's as if the universe continues to say, oh yeah, and throws you down deeper and deeper and deeper.
Right.
Until you finally get to the point where you can't run anymore.
Mm.
And then your ascension begins.
Let's keep talking dirty.
Under the Bridge is this song about, not wanting to have to re-experience certain lows and loneliness and just the common human experience of perils.
Mm-hmm.
And people love connecting to a common peril.
When I write lyrics for my songs, I'm not thinking of this, of making things better in this world at all, but I am thinking of making things better in other spiritual planes.
People make the association that in order to be a really good rock star, you have had to endure a lot of psychological pain.
You just know the whole process of a child looking up to a rock star, and the rock star being something to him that subconsciously he connects to a great deal. That I just know it's a really healthy process.
Kiss me, keep up on me. Stick with me. All over the world, people are listening to right now.
I feel that the person that I am to somebody else who doesn't know me, the person that they think I am is an equally valid person as the actual person sitting here right now. Like, I think that it's equally as real as me sitting here.
Do you feel that the band is your family? Would you say that's the bond you have?
Yeah, I kind of think of that as being the center of my life.
It's far easier to think that behind the scenes you're doing something wild than the way you really live.
Right.
To see you doing yoga and to pray together and to be so conscious of your nutrition and your environment. That's a phenomenal thing.
It's so much more thrilling and exciting and wild to me to feel like there's this enormous field of growth in front of me.
You're very devoted to your daughter, Clara.
I've got to be there for her because I'm her father and I'm the only father she'll have and she's a kid and I've got to be there no matter what. And so that sort of unconditional giving no matter what, which I feel is, you know, one of the most basic, important spiritual principles of a way to live, has totally influenced me as a musician.
How do you see the younger generation?
There's no space for kids to think and to be.
No time, is that what you mean?
Space, not just time, but space in the air. There's all this information flying around.
Excellent.
And there's no room for kids to think, to develop their own personalities. Hit me, you can't hurt me. Suck my kiss. Kiss me, please, for fuck me.
Stick with me. Let's keep talking the dead. Down the main sweet sacred bit. Your mouth was made to suck my. Intrigued with how thought creates form.
Right.
And how form influences your thoughts.
Yeah.
So I watch that dynamic of spiritual alchemy in people.
So it excites you and you get...
Yeah, well, you know, when I do readings on people, when I do a health evaluation on you, what I'm looking for, quite frankly, is where you have invested your spirit into physical matter. And how much it's costing you spiritually, and the wise use of your spirit. I'm not a voyeur. You know, I don't go around and scan people.
Right.
To be honest with you, I'm not interested in doing that any more than you are singing in every corner of every room you walk into in your life. Where my help is most beneficial is at the stage in which you are actually developing the illness. Because I'm able to say, I'll tell you where you're losing power, and I'll tell you where, and I'll tell you why. And if you can shift this, the likelihood of this happening is reduced dramatically. You see yourself retiring soon? Or?
No.
Okay. What about other ambitions?
Being more at peace with myself so that I can be more at peace with all the people that I come into contact with and not destroy relationships with all of my fucked up character defects. I also want to be a dad. You know, I just like the kids.
It's like, baby time.
I like to, you know, spend time with kids and have a place to give that unconditional love and do the family thing, have the unit, you know, feel the joy of, you know, we're a little team here, and you know, I know it's harder than it sounds. It takes a lot of work.
There's a constant kind of communication, not with human beings.
You, just for clarity's sake, are you referring to a non-physical?
Yeah.
Like an angel.
Yeah. I don't know. I know it involves a language that I don't consciously understand, that subconsciously somewhere in myself I do understand, and I know that I can translate ideas that they give me in their technical form, in their language, into a musical representation of that idea without being conscious of it. I know I'm doing that.
There aren't many people in your occupation that would admit to feeling that they are, should we use the word, co-creating or co-scripting music with an angel.
I'm
spiritual practice like?
Mine out like my discipline?
Yeah.
At the moment, I meditate twice a day.
Mm-hmm.
I pray every morning. I pray every night. I pray before and after every show that I play. I pray before I eat, but only when I'm by myself.
What would you define as the difference between prayer and meditation?
I would say that prayer is talking to God,
mm-hmm.
and that meditation is listening to God.
People don't realize that there is a phenomenal spiritual difference between a promise and a vow.
Right.
A vow is something that is a promise that goes vertically, and a human promise is a horizontal
right.
thing that can be negotiated. I don't think people know the nature of the sacred and how intimate that role is in someone's life, that you do truly have an angel.
Often I'll hear people complain about their situation, about how unhappy they are, but they really, it's like for them to want to change, they have to completely surrender to the unknown
mm-hmm.
and say, okay, I'm going to, whatever it's going to be, I'm going to change and
mm-hmm.
I'm going to go into this risky place.
People want to grow consciously,
right.
but they want selective consciousness.
Yeah, they want it so it doesn't hurt.
Yeah, and you know, they want to sort of... well, I don't want this to change, and I don't want that to change.
Right.
And what I've realized is that people are frightened of God more than anything else, because the belief is that as you pursue spirituality, it's going to cost.
Right.
And there is an exchange.
Yeah.
You know, that's absolutely true. And it's the change that goes with surrender and with finally realizing I cannot make my physical world more important than the spiritual.
Parts to being human. You know, there's two people in every one of us. There's the ego, which you just described,
yeah.
which is the part of us that believes that who I am is what I have, what I do, what others think of me, how much better I am than other people,
yeah,
and,
yeah.
and like living in all these low frequencies. And then there's the other part of us, the higher or the sacred self, that says, I don't care whether I win or lose, whether I'm better than anybody else, how much I have, I'm not, all I want is to be at peace.
But is there not a time for a low frequency? Just when you're sort of relaxing, and
you start using your intuition,
yeah.
you start using creativity, you
mm.
start using insight. These are higher frequencies
yeah.
than fear and stress and anxiety. And you just call that in. You can call that in at will. You can do that in your emotional health, you can do that in physical health, you can do that in consciousness. Einstein said nothing happens until something moves.
The sound "ah" does appear in the word God.
And it appears in the name for God in every language in the world. And it's the sound of creation. I bet you you're one of the only rock musicians in the world doing yoga.
Is that true? It seems pretty popular nowadays, I thought. I could already do the splits and stuff.
Uh-huh.
So I was able to progress at it really quickly.
You're not
so,
kidding. I mean, if you can put your legs behind your head.
Yeah.
Let me see that. That's astonishing.
But
you know, there's a lot of mind in that too. There's a lot of, you know, like yoga, you know, the word yoga means union.
Mm-hmm.
What meditation does in yoga is very similar.
Mm-hmm.
Is it puts you in touch with the oneness. You know, it's like you can't divide silence. You
mm-hmm.
cut silence in half as many times as you can cut it in half. You can. It's indivisible. When I find my peace of old Zen proverb that said that it's the silence between the notes that makes the music.
A note that occurs after 20 seconds of silence is not the same note that would have occurred before the 20 seconds if you just heard the note at 0
yeah.
seconds.
Mm.
You know, the note that occurs to 20 seconds or the note that occurs in 40 seconds, those are new notes, you know, those are notes that are created out of the silence.
Out of the silence,
and the
yeah.
silence is part of the note. And
yeah.
in the silence, in that case, obviously if it's the note lasts for 1 second and the 20 seconds is the silence, then
mm.
the 20 seconds
yeah.
is a bigger part of the note than the note itself.
That's exactly right,
yeah.
You gotta let it be. pursues success in life is to fall in love with what you do. And then what you do is you sell the love. You know, and that's what you're doing up there. You're really not selling music. You're selling, your love.
We're in love with the music and each other and what we create.
And
is
that
very
really
special.
Comes across. There was a real strong sense of love. I mean, there were people, you know, like putting their fingers up in the air and
flashing the metal.
Right.
Flash the metal.
Right. I've got 8 children.
Do you really?
6 daughters and 2 sons. Yeah.
You are
6 beautiful daughters. Yeah, well, I got them. It's all my pleasure. My wife is a stud.
It's your pleasure.
Right.
That's awesome.
When I ask people about the Red Hot Chili Peppers, it's always, I feel like they're part of me and I'm part of them.
Yeah,
rather than it's something that I'm buying.
That's, you know, about the greatest compliment that I think that we can ever get.
You think about your life, you know, you come into the world with nothing.
Yeah.
You leave with nothing.
Yeah.
So your life is like a parenthesis in eternity.
Yeah.
That's it. Okay. This is what you get while you're here. And the only thing you can do with your life is give it away. It's bitter, baby, and it's very sweet. Oh, the miracles of put them on my
I don't feel that we're just playing for the people that are there. I feel that we're playing for spirits from many different dimensions, mm-hmm. and I feel that we're playing for all of the history of music. You know, I think of all, like, I refer to the history of music so much, and for my musical education and my education as a person, that's been the thing that has kept me on a righteous path in my life.
If there's only one force in the universe,
yeah.
called God, or whatever you want to call it.
Right.
And there's no such thing as time, I mean, if that's what quantum physics teaches us. It really means that the same force that was in Shakespeare and Bach and Rumi and Buddha and Jesus and Mother Teresa and Martin Luther King and, you know, and that same force is in every one of us. It's like we're connected in some way.
Yeah.
Spiritually, to everything and everyone who ever was or ever will be.
Yeah, and that concept to me is absolutely thrilling. Where I go, I just don't know. Now I'm out in the snow in Mexico. When I find my peace of mind, I won't be there for the end of
Butterfly has been a part of my name since I was 7 years old because I was hiking in the mountains in Pennsylvania and I had a very difficult childhood and I wanted to quit living at a very early age.
Uh-huh.
And a butterfly came and landed on me and stayed on me for hours while I was hiking when I was little girl.
You thought maybe I'll hang in there?
The tree I was in is over 1,000 years old.
Uh-huh.
It's 200 feet tall. It's 15 feet in diameter at the base, which is about 10 people our size with arms outstretched to go around the base. It stands forever with the grove around it protected forever. Now, we still have a lot of work to do, but, you know, that tree can stand for another 1,000 years easy. I went through so much, and the first 3 months, I nearly died from exposure to cold.
Right.
I had a twin propeller helicopter with 300 mile an hour updrafts hovering above my head trying to rip me out. I had a 24-hour-a-day security siege with guards at the base of the tree trying to starve me. They cut off my supplies, were trying to starve me down. I had air horns blowing all night to cause sleep deprivation.
They were just trying to get rid of you?
Yeah. We continue at the path we're going now in your great grandchildren. Have any original force left, you know, and so I feel like that's a big part of why I do it. I want them to have the same magical experience that I had when I first came
here. I saw the rainforest there, the Indonesian rainforest, and it looked like some giant, the head the size of the moon, taking a huge razor and just going across the whole country. I was like, oh my God.
Northern California, looks just like what you said. It looks like an animal with a mane. It's just like, every, and miles of these clear cuts. And this these companies take 7-foot chainsaws to take the old growth down. They clear cut it into the ground. Then they light it on fire with diesel fuel or with napalm, where it burns for days. Then they spray 40 gallons of diesel fuel per acre onto the land to carry herbicides. And all of this is known to cause cancer and birth deformities. Being still and being open are two of the most profound things we can do in the world today. One of the most radical things we can do in the world today.
Yeah.
Because everything is pulling us in a million different directions. I mean, look at it out there. It's like bigger, better, faster now, bigger, better, faster now. And it's just like, whoa!
Oh, it's got old me.
People's power is their ability to recognize that they changed the world. Their power is what enables a person to stand up against injustice, that gives them the chance to say, you know, I don't agree with that, and I'm going to say it, and I'm going to say it loud, and you can make fun of me, you can throw me in jail, you can beat me up, you can threaten me, but I'm not going to back down.
Did you have rituals that you did?
Actually, climbing the tree was a ritual, and I didn't even realize it.
So you went down, you climbed up and down?
Not to the ground. The tree is 200 feet tall,
right.
And I would climb 100 feet of that about four times a day. I've never been very ritualistic,
right.
But I started, while I was in the tree, I do believe in prayer, right. And I believe you can pray to whatever you feel that prayer is going to, and it's just collective consciousness. Right. And so I started having a prayer. May every breath that enters my body be a prayer. Because that is, then my life becomes my ritual,
right.
That way. And that's been very powerful.
That's awesome. Did them make waves
of graceful pleasure? On our public lands, we lost, in the last year, we lost $1.2 billion to logging,
right.
On our public lands. So not only did they take our forests, but they took our money,
right.
To do it.
Wow.
So we're working on what's happening now is we're empowering the people and we're going to start doing people's initiatives.
Right. Is there anything that, like, you know, all the people that come on to us and watch this that they can do to, in terms of, like, boycotting or writing letters? Or
absolutely, they can. There's a lot of different things. Number one, they need to know that a lot of times if you go and you're buying a hot tub, a sauna, a deck, siding for your house or a fence,
yeah.
A lot of times it's from Redwood.
Yeah.
Don't buy it. Begin speaking out. I believe very strongly in the power of words. And the third thing is in contacting local representatives, whoever they are, and letting them know that forest issues are important.
I love the ancient redwood so much. I spend a lot of time up in Big Sur up there. You know,
mm-hmm.
There's a lot of beautiful trees up there. I like to walk around there.
Yeah.
An incredible feeling.
I went to go climb a tree in the park near here, and they had it wrapped in these electrical wires for these lights, and I was just like, that was messing with my energy. I couldn't go climb a tree and climb around the cords, so I gave up and
I love climbing
sat
trees.
In the grass.
Me and my daughter spent a week climbing trees just last week.
Nice.
Yeah, but only little ones, because she's the little.